Hello everybody, it's Sunday 8th of August 2021, currently 4 PM in the afternoon, and we're going to do our usual backtesting session. Just only difference that today is going to be a different one than the last, than the previous ones that I did. I recorded 8 minutes where I chose randomly. Let me show here. The random calendar between December 2012 and December 2013, which shows a Tuesday, which Wednesday, which is 10th of April 2013. As you can see, you don't see because the recording was gone, but we were coming from a bad week for the US economy. We had higher unemployment claims, we had a really bad NFP, and a slightly lower unemployment rate. And that's the reason why we saw this spike on gold, especially on the 1 minute here, as you can see. And we're not going to try to see what we can figure out only using this time frame. I can even add some daily, because since I don't know exactly this period, I need some higher time frame analysis. Okay, very good. Okay, so we know that 2012, 2013 were the years of coming out of the financial crisis. 2008 that dragged until 2012, 11, 12, starting to see some tapering talks and something like what's the word, interest rate hikes. So we're going to see if we can get any clue. Do you want to clone or you don't want? This is around 1816, 13. There you go. This is a high time frame trend line. These two, I have no idea where they're coming from, so we're going to remove them. We don't want to disturb us. Okay, so we're coming to from NFP. We saw some ranging. We created a low. We are sort of in another block as usual. This is probably Friday. Tuesday, 10th, 9th of April 2013. We saw, so this is actually, you see, I'm stupid. This is yesterday. What happened yesterday at 2? Very interesting stuff. Yesterday. Jolts opening. That was probably some headline or something that at New York open brought the price up that way. Weird. So this one was the NFP. And then something, some talks. Okay, so we are ready to start. So we want to identify on the high time frame. Let's start on the daily time frame, which we are here. We identified a bearish trend line. What we want to identify is also the price point. So this is the previous lows. So we are going, can consider previous lows as a safe sell point on a high time frame. Of course, we have other many. This more is more a more of recent price sensitivity areas, more than key level, more than I don't know, my brain is gone. Of really price, really important price points. Okay, so what are we going to see on the daily is that we can consider sales below 1543-ish, because these are the previous lows that brought to these last highs. So that's what we consider break of market structure. And we're going now to see into the intraday. Okay, what is the trend? What is going on? Okay, as you can see on the hourly. Okay, 1569 500. Very good. Okay. As you can see on the lower time frame, this one doesn't make much sense. Let's see if we can see some reaction. It's more or less the key level. So since we are trading as a scalper, we don't want to take too much into consideration that one. And we're going to have some key points here directly on the hourly time frame. So we start to see the previous lows here to consider taking buys above. We are at this key level, so we can consider a bounce. Since the trend is bullish, consider that during the London, now is midnight, so we still have Asian session. We consider that during London, we can have a pullback to this level, to this price sensitivity area. And to go back up, to continue up. If we see a break below to the key level, it's still bullish. We're going to analyze until we break below this key level, which is 1569. We are still in a bullish bias. Okay, so on the 1 minute, we should have everything. If it updates, oh, okay, very good. And we have the trend line over there. Okay, so what we are going to do is jump to London session. As always, okay, you see there was not much movement either. As you can see, just ranging. So our ideas as per pre-London, let me zoom in a little bit for you guys. We are still in a bullish trend, bullish bias, because we saw NFP last week. We saw some weak unemployment claims from last week as well. We are going towards unemployment claims tomorrow. So we can either continue up, but of course, as a scalper, we want to take advantage even of small ranges, like above this line, which is the previous highs created on the hourly time frame. Why don't you like to clone them? Okay, there they are. You see, these are the previous highs on the 1 minute that we need to break in order to continue up. As you can see, it's still 25 pips range, so it's not, it can be scalped pretty easily if we have small enough stop loss positioning. Okay, these are the previous eyes. You see, they are kind of messy on the 1 minute, and why we're going to fix them. Very good. Okay, you see the reaction was there, and now we start our session, London session. Okay. As per last price action, we can consider even buys above these last highs after we see a pullback of London Open, which might happen now. So let's keep moving. Let's see the reaction in these previous lows. Okay, we saw a break below and we saw some impulsive reaction. Right now we're testing the lows, so we're not considering yet the buys. We are going below the previous lows. We're not testing yet also these previous hourly time frame highs. We are because we didn't update on the hourly time frame. This one, please update. Very good. Let me zoom in on the hourly. As you can see, we are testing the wicks, not the bodies. We gotta be honest. So let's see if we see some setup creating. Perfect. Okay, so we got a test, full test of the previous highs and immediate reaction. Let's see if we can see some exhaustion of the sellers to take a properly possible advantage of buys. We are engulfing it. We have 10 pips stop loss. This will be our high risk, high reward area. We are starting the set. Okay, no, we just started the hourly candle, so we might be creating a upper wick to continue down. So I'm not going to enter because we don't have a lower wick yet on the hourly time frame. Okay, very good. Okay, let's see if we make a double bottom. We continue down. Looks like we are continuing down below these previous highs. Of course, we can still retest. Okay, these actual body highs, which are here. Let's see if we have a reaction. Nice rejection. If we come up break and retest, we can consider taking buys. Back into the range. Do we have a double bottom setting up? Might be. Let's see if we have some bullish momentum coming in. Okay, this looks nice. Was 12 pips of movement, really good. Let's see now the reaction at the previous highs. Okay, back into the range, not what we want. Okay, and we are going below. Let's see if we go and we test the key level. This could actually be a nice retest. New hourly candle, lower wick. Didn't make a new lower wick. You see the upper wick, as I told you, really nice. Would I consider sells over there? Over here would have been nice, like 20 pips. Short ranges, let's say. But we can see that might be some opportunity for quick scalps in continuation of the let's see where it closed this one. If it closed like this or engulfing this one, I might consider taking a 5-7 pips risk sell to go to the key level. So let's see how it moves now. Okay, that was a really nice, but it's not anymore 5-7, it's more 10. This is a nice decision point. This new hourly made an upper wick. It made indeed and retested the previous body highs. If we give them 7 pips, we have a 3-1 to retest the key level on the hourly time frame. But it is a counter trend. Do we know if we go here or to the key level? So it's better for me not to rush entries on the counter trend. But this is what I was saying. We just traveled over here like 10 pips. We reacted at the previous, these previous highs. Let me just. You here? Good. And that was it. So it was not, was good not entering. Let's see if. Okay, very good. So we made a good choice not entering, understanding the high time frame price points. Now we're looking to bounce from these lows. Looks like we made a new lower, a nice lower wick on the hourly time frame, reacting to these previous lows. And it's possible that we might start resume the bullish trend as per fundamental analysis. Okay, we are not bad. We can even 5 to 15. Do I have a confirmation of bullish? So we have the hourly making new lows, but we are at this key level. So for me, it's not yet a good opportunity. Exactly. Very good. Not rushing anything. You don't remember, you don't have to be the first, you have to be the second. Very good. Advice by Uncle Ted. Okay, we're coming towards the hourly hand. This is going to close nice and bullish. That's it. Let's see if we make a new lower wick to retest these previous highs and then continuation up. I want a lower wick to retest these previous highs on the 1 minute also. What the actual fuck? That was not a retest. I told you I want a retest, not a meltdown. Okay, nice. Good to know. We are coming. We are still in London session, so big volume coming in, big candles. But we are creating another block here, so it's not so clean, the price action. Reacting at these previous highs, exactly. So I'm going to take safer buys only above here now. I'm not going to play this range. As you know, gold tends to give much, much cleaner action than this one. So there's no reason to fight in a range. Not especially if the levels are just and not fixed historical levels. So we're starting to see some nice retest again. We're coming towards the end of the hour, so we might see some nice action. Never mind. Never mind. Okay, coming towards the end of the hourly candle, which they're making up with this bullish close with no wick on the top. Really little. We're closing now bearish this hourly candle. Let's see if we close with no body. Okay, so the hourly close. Bearish, not so strong. We are now creating a possible lower wick, no wick on top to continue down, possible lower wick to continuation up. Lower wick can fill this range and then spike up. We are our last hour of trading. Wow, we got to the key level. Sorry. Let's see if we can continue down. Let's see if we can continue down and take advantage of sells until this level at least. Oh, we get a nice rejection. You see, bullish candles are not that strong. we are going to retest these previous lows. Let's see if we have some reaction. I don't care about you. I want to. Oh gosh, where are you coming from? Okay, delete. I want to see the reaction here. Let's see. I see buyers not being able to close above. Let's see if we see some not even strong. This is not a really weak bearish candle. So I want to see some engulfing one to consider sells. As you can see, fake out. Or nope, continuation up. Let's see. It's a deeper retest, but we're coming towards New York Open. Starting to like this price action, to be honest. Exactly. I was kidding. That's no trade. Let's see where he closes the hourly candle. If he manages to close below in 2 minutes. Okay, the hourly candle closed below the key level. Remember that today there was someone talking the FOMC minutes at 1. So it's in an hour. So we are closing now below. Let's see if we make an upper wick. Okay, this was a strong upper wick for sure. Let's see if we can then continuation down. Okay. Let's see where it closes. Poof! Rejection. Got instantly rejected. That's why you wait for the candle close. How many pips are we? 11. If I give 15, do I have 45? Do I have 45 pips? I have 10 pips to the last close. Luckily, we didn't enter. And for me, this is the day. So this was a no trade day, but I'm curious, I want to see how the price played out. You see why you don't enter when the range is so small? You see why I didn't enter sells? Because it was only 10, 15 pips. You don't want this tight range. You don't want to trade those ranges. That's why you always look on the left. Then, if you have confirmation, this was probably New York Stock Exchange. But look at these candles. How can you consider, where do you enter? Tell me where do you enter? The only thing you can consider is here. If you want, let's go back on the 1 minute. But this was probably FOMC speakers. So okay, I want to see here. You see with multiple rejections, you are here and you see on the hourly time frame, this is the same hourly time frame I don't know if, yeah, but this is okay. So we have the first 30-minute candle closed with a full wick of other flows. You can consider, if we see a reaction here, let's see, consider filling it for like 30 pips. So you see a reaction, you see, okay, but this is just one candle. Actually, this is still a 15 pips stop loss to 2 to 1 and 3 to 1 here, more or less. Let's see. Okay. 38. So I would have taken partials here. Okay, no, I take partials around 30. So I take partials around here. I let the rest run risk-free. Okay, so let me try. So you see this rejection. Okay, you don't enter here. This is picture perfect entry. But you start to see. Let's see, okay. You start to see impulsive candle. You enter here. Of course, now you can give 12 pips. Let's go to the end of it, the candle. Okay, you see, we didn't break below, but we have the full range to cover. So I want to enter on the next candle if I see that it makes an upper wick and then continues down. Okay. When it was bearish, I want to enter. Nice, I like it, I like it. Okay. Okay, here. So I enter 15, this is 45. Okay. So let's go, let's move on. We see this. Okay, and now we go. Okay, we test. Nice one. Okay, 13 pips. Let's see now. Go slower. Okay, so now we are 30 pips. We close partials, 80%, and we let the rest run risk-free to the eventual take profit. Want to risk, you put the stop loss here, so at least you know that you have, like you would have if you enter here, more or less. So you have some gains anyway. Okay. Okay, you see, this was a mistake, but this is after 40 minutes. This was a mistake because why? I could have taken my full profit there. That's why you have to follow the plan. why is I show you exactly why you have to follow the plan. And just give me a second. Okay. Very good. Just give me a second, just a second. Okay, very, very good. So, we got our entry here. We put our stop loss here. This is 30 pips, 15 pips, really, really sorry. Pips, stop loss. We got our first take profit here. At 30 pips, which is 2 to 1. Then, big mistake, which we're going to be bad here. What I did was move stop loss from break even. Granted profits is scared slash greedy. Very good. This is because, okay, might be inside, I don't care. This This would have hit our real take profit. Real TP2, 45 pips, would have hit MCM with 20% risk. Hey, you damn us. Let me just write. And we will see. Very good.